Boa noite a todos. Hoje atraí uma poesia de Rainer Maria Rilke, que nasceu em 1875 e faleceu em 1926. Não vou poder ler em português porque não há tradução, embora ele tenha sido um escritor de língua alemã e tenha escrito também em francês. Neste livro que consegui, esta edição, consegui só em alemão e inglês, de modo que vou ler uns poemas em inglês deste escritor, que é um dos mais originais escritores do século XX, porque a poesia dele está, digamos que, entre a filosofia de Nietzsche e a escultura de Rodin. Esta coleção reflete o desenvolvimento da sua arte, desde a primitiva exploração sobre o amor e a morte, sobre a angústia e o êxtase. Portanto, é uma poesia do seu último período, quando ele estava bastante aflito e, portanto, com receio da morte, porque teve uma doença grave e estava alienado pelo terror. Portanto, vou começar a ler, digamos que ao acaso, alguma da poesia que selecionei. Este livro está dividido em vários capítulos. Um é o livro das horas, outro é o livro das gravuras, outro é o livro dos poemas, outro é Requiem, outros são notas de Malte Lauritz Bridge, poemas que foram depois colecionados, as elegias de Duino e, portanto, os sonetos a Orfeu. E mais uma vez, Uncollected Poems. Portanto, abstraindo de todos estes conteúdos bem definidos, eu vou ler algumas poesias ao acaso e esta intitula-se I Am, O Anxious One. Don't you hear my voice? I Am, O Anxious One. Don't you hear my voice surging forth? With all my earthly feelings, they earn so high that they have sprouted wings and whitely fly in circles around your face. My soul, dressed in silence, rises up and stands alone before you. Can't you see? Don't you know that my prayer is growing ripe upon your vision as upon a tree? If you are the dreamer, I am what you dream, but when you want to wake, I am your wish, and I grow strong with all magnificence, and turn myself into a star's vast silence above the strange and distant city, time. Portanto, é o estilo de poesia que é bastante apelativa e modernista. Outro poema denomina-se A Pantera. De Panthère, in the Jardin des Plantes Paris. Portanto, ele põe um subtítulo em francês, mas eu vou ler em inglês. His vision from the constantly passing bars has grown so weary that it cannot hold anything else. It seems to him there are a thousand bars, and behind the bars, no world. As he paces in cramped circles over and over, the movement of his powerful soft strides is like a ritual dance around the center in which a mighty will stands paralyzed. Only at times the curtain of the peoples lifts quietly, an image enters in. Rushes down through the tensed, arrested muscles, plunges into the heart and is gone. Depois temos aqui um poema também bastante bonito que é Before Summer Rain. Suddenly from all the green around you, something you don't know what has disappeared. You feel it creeping closer to the window, in total silence. From the nearby wood, you hear the urgent whistling of a plover, reminding you of someone Saint Jerome. So much solitude and passion come from that one voice, whose fierce request the dawn power will grant. The walls with their ancient portraits glide away from us cautiously, as though they weren't supposed to hear what we are saying. And reflected on the faded tapestries now, the chill and certain sunlight of those long childhood hours when you were so afraid. São, portanto, poemas sincopados que refletem bem um carisma muito intenso do estilo de interiorização que ele exprime ao retratar os seus sentimentos. Um poema também interessante é também do Jardin des Plantes de Paris, que ele põe também em subtítulo, e é sobre os flamingos. De flamingos. With all the subtle paints of Fragonard, no more their red and white could be expressed than someone would convey about his mistress by telling you she was lovely lying there, still soft with sleep. They rise above the green grass and lightly sway on their long pink stems, side by side, like enormous feathery blossoms, seducing more seductively than preen themselves. Till, necks curling, they sink their large, pale eyes into the softness of their down, where apple red and jet black lie concealed. A shriek of envy shakes the parrot cage. But they stretched out, astonished, and one by one stride into their imaginary world. São poemas muito próprios, muito sutis e muito belos. Aqui um outro intitula-se You Who Never Arrived. Tu que nunca chegaste. You would never arrived in my arms, beloved, who were lost from the start. I don't even know what songs would please you. I have given up trying to recognize you in the surging wave of the next moment. All the immense images in me, the far-off deeply felt landscape, cities, towers and bridges, and unsuspected turns in the past, and those powerful ends that were once pulsing with the life of gods, of the gods, all rise within me to mean you, who forever elude me. You, beloved, who are all the garden I have never gazed at, longing, an open window in a country house, and you almost stepped out, pensive, to meet me. Streets that I chanced upon, you had just walked down them and vanished. And sometimes, in a shop, the mirrors were still dizzy with your presence and startled gave back my too sudden image. Who knows, perhaps the same bird echoed through both of us yesterday, separate in the evening. Este poema é bastante interessante, tem imensos poemas, mas são muito longos, e tem aqui um que é Lamente, muito mais curto, que eu vou ler. Lament. Whom will you cry to art, more and more lonely, your past struggles on through incomprehensible mankind, all the more futile perhaps for keeping to its direction, keeping on toward the future, toward what has been lost. Once you lamented, what was it? A fallen berry of jubilation and ripe. But now the old tree of my jubilation in breaking, in the storm it is breaking, my slow tree of joy. Loveliest in my invisible landscape, you that made me more known to the invisible angels. Penso que, a finalizar, vou ler um outro poema que é As Once the Winged Energy of Delight. As once the winged energy of delight carried you over childhood's dark abyss. Now beyond your own life built the great arch of unimagined bridges. Wonders happen if we can succeed in passing through the harshest danger, but only in a bright and purely granted achievement can we realize the wonder. To work with things in the indescribable relationship is not too hard for us. The pattern grows more intricate and subtle, and being swept along is not enough. Take your pectizes powers and stretch them out until they span the chasm between two contradictions, for the God wants to know himself in you. Como tive ali uma pausa neste poema, vou ler ainda mais um para não me sentir tão deslocada, e portanto este intitula-se What Birds Plunge Through Is Not the Intimate Space. What birds plunge through is not the intimate space in which you see all forms intensified. Out in the open, you would be denied yourself, would disappear into that vastness. Space reaches from us and constitutes the world. To know a tree in its true element, through inner space around it, from that pure abundance in you, surround it with restraint. It has no limits, not till it is held in your renouncing, is it truly there. E por hoje terminei com alguns poemas deste maravilhoso poeta que realmente em língua alemã fez furor, mas que teve uma vida difícil porque faleceu bastante cedo e portanto não pôde cumprir e completar uma obra que seria riquíssima, e portanto ficamos aqui com uma imagem um pouco pálida, mas é já alguma coisa para compreender o sentido e a poesia dele, que não se pode dizer que seja intrincada, é bastante simples de compreender, mas que revela sentimentos bastante puros e elevados, e portanto também apresenta e deixa transparecer um sentimento profundo de solidão. E por hoje é tudo. Desejo para todos um resto de boa semana e um bom jantar. Boa noite.